people, welcome back, Bossman Show, True Speech Thursday for you on the Bossman Radio Network and BossmanRadioShow.com. Me and my man True Speech are back with you going into year five of our radio careers together, which means that my name is JR, JR the Bossman, Boss of Bossman. His name is True Speech, Truer Speech. And I want to say before we get started in this year, can we please do better about our names? But judged by our emails, dog, already, it's same thing, different year.
Dog, I know. The emails are already proven. This is going to be a very interesting year already, bro. Already. And even, with, what, 4 or 5 days into the dang on New Year? Starting off on this nonsense.
And, dog, when I promo the email address, why did some cat hit me about why plus size porn is on the rise? It's not what you think. Really?
Dude, that, like, it had absolutely nothing to do with nothing. And the relevance was so just out of the blue. I'm like, what the hell is he talking about? I'm like, what? Like, it's one thing to say something reckless, bro. But to say something that's so far out of left field that you just have no bearing on what's going on, it's just, it was remarkable, dog. Just to say the least, it was remarkable.
And yes. And folks, our first email address this year is going to be to Walter. Speech, he started on New Year's Eve bothering me. Then it went to New Year's Day bothering me. Bothered me on Saturday. He called me. He called the studio, and they gave them my personal number to Walter. Dog, first of all, why he do that, first of all? And just know I cussed him out earlier today about the studio. Don't give him my number no more. Nobody else, please. And dog, he emails me while I'm out at First Saturdays at Halo Ultra Lounge here in Atlanta. Listen to their email. Boss, can I call you? Quote, I need you, K-N-E-E-D, you for some, Walter. I sent over the Speech, who laughed his ass off.
It was entertaining. It was definitely entertaining.
Then I hit his back. I said, Walter, please email me your concern. Boss, quote, I-E-Y-E, Ratter, Ratter, R-A-D-D-E-R, I talk to you. Then email you, Walter. And when he called me, his concern was that he could not deliver a female her gift, and she quit answering his phone calls. How does he handle that? How about take the gift back to where you bought it from, say get your money back, and tell her kick rocks? But obviously, he couldn't wait for me to tell him that on the air. He had to call me and email me while I'm out and bug me, Speech. Your take on Walter's situation and Walter doing what he does best, which is overly contact me and you.
Dude, Walter, bro, we can't hold your hand through everything, man. Like, look, I'm all down for helping you out, my brother. I really am. We here to help. We are. But you a grown-ass man, dog. We can't babysit you all the time, man. Dude, if you can't get in touch with her to give her a gift, guess what? You got two options. Hold on to it until you can't get in touch with her. Like JR said, take it back, get your money back. Me personally, I'm taking it back. I'm like, okay, well, I can't get in touch with you. Obviously, you don't want it. So I'm going to go take it back. Not even being cheap. It's like, I don't know when I'm going to see you again. Might hold it for a couple of days. Might even hold it for about a period of 7 days. But to be honest, knowing me, hell, I might hold it for a business week. 5 days. That's what you get. Monday through Friday. Other than that, Saturday, I'm taking it right back, getting my damn money back. Just being honest. So, Walter, bro, we can't literally put the training wheels on and walk you through this game of life, man. You got to figure it out on your own sometimes, man. If you got a problem, send us an email. We'll talk about it. But damn, bro, come on, man. Come on. Jesus.
Dog, what would he do without us, dog? What would he be without me and you right now?
Lost. Absolutely 100% lost, bro. To be honest, and not even second guess it, you'd be lost.
Exactly. We have another email that came in, dog. It referred to us as, quote, Moster Boz, I guess he didn't miss the boss, the Moster Boz, M-O-S-T-E-R-B-O-Z, and Moster Spiel. I guess he means Mr. Speech, obviously. I'm absolutely disgusted at the women I'm meeting in my town. All of them seem cool at the jump, talking that same initial noise and what have you. Then, what prompted my email is me seeing a female I call myself trying to date, and I catch her in a Facebook group. Facebook, dog, already Facebook. Already. Participate in, quote, Matchmaker Monday. When I've been trying to see her in the past week to no avail. Oh, my God. And then these H's talk about how we be playing and bleep. I've been nothing but straight with this B, and this is the thanks I get. Gentlemen, I think I'm about to go back to the old me. This has been on the up and up bleep. Obviously, ain't working my racial slurs. Love the show, Andre.
Andre was upset. Like, dog, I mean,
exactly.
But he has good reason to be. I mean, my whole thing is this, though. If you're in a situation with a chick, right, and y'all talking or whatever, dating and what have you, and I'm assuming that they were dating by the tone of his email and his email's inflection. I'm assuming his voice was a little inflected too. You know what I mean? So I'm assuming he was speaking in a tone where he actually cared about the young lady. Now, you ran into what I would like to say, what I would really like to describe it as, but, you know, gotta watch what I say. So you ran into an SOS young lady. You fill in the blank. The first word is full. The second one is of, and the third one rhymes with spit. That's what you ran into. You ran into a young lady that's SOS. To be honest with you, and then at this point, there's not too much that you can do, but take it for what it is, chalk it up, and move on. And that's really it. You know, I mean, you see where she's coming from, and at the end of the day, if that's the type of shenanigans that she's putting down, you got to make a choice. That's what it is.
You ask me, bro, she deserves to be single. She deserves it. She deserves being single by herself. Who's the doing shit, Andre? No, ma'am. You pull those shenanigans, you deserve to be by yourself, if you ask the
right,
boss.
Right.
And another email, Homeboys Show. Man, y'all N-words know where I can score some government cheese and ties for suits. Carlos.
No, I have not the slightest nor faintest idea where one could score some government cheese. I ain't had government cheese since the days of my youth. So I don't think you could just go pick some up. You know what I mean? You gotta go through a process to get approved to get some government cheese. I would start with your local welfare office, maybe. I'm just going out on a limb here. I don't know. But, I'm not a social worker, brother, so I really can't help him on that one, dog. I can't even call that one, brother, to be honest with you.
And my thing is, why he emailed us about this? Why do you think that we would know how to get you some of these things? And ties for, what do you mean by, quote, ties for suits? You mean like a bow tie, a necktie? Is that what you're trying to go with? Or why don't you just say suit ties or not ties for suits? That language right there threw me off for a minute there. Like, really? Ties for suits. And the final email of the day speech is Ross and Blue. I guess I know who that is. I guess I'm Ross and you're Blue. Do you N-words
right.
know how I feel? I added a racial slur on Facebook who I threw to another racial slur. I guess he meant new. And this new racial slur gonna ask me about a B I used to F with. I didn't know racial slurs come through other racial slurs pages like that. Me and Bra done came and gone, it's been years. But the principal racial slurs. What's up with this racial slur? My racial slurs. Science centric.
Wow. I'm going to be honest with you. That was a very, a very racially charged email. Like, I mean, that was, you know, I would hope that he, the brother was, you know, African American the way he was slanging that word around, but,
Exactly.
Jesus. That one was rough, man. I don't really know how to take that, to be honest.
Exactly.
That one was, But, I mean, you know, it's, that's not really part of the game anymore. When people still trip over, I don't want to say, well, I'm going to just call a spade if you're tripping over a chick that he's a tourist dog, that ain't part of the game. These new dudes got the whole game twisted up. I mean, where I come from, it's it ain't yours, and y'all ain't in a solid relationship, and at the end of the day, you ain't really got too much of a talk. So I guess he threw him some play to a sucker, because, I mean, where I come from, and I know where y'all come from, part of the game is, man, if you ain't stake your claim on it, you can't trip on it. Period. Just being honest. So, you gotta watch who you associate yourself with there, partner.
Exactly. And Cedric, calm down on the racial slurs because we don't want to incite a racial uprising. It's potentially hazardous. Right. Okay?
just hazardous, man. We can't have that. We can't do that, man.
Nah, it's the first show of the year, dog.
Exactly. We're trying to usher in a new wave for the new year, man. Not so hot, not so racially charged. Trying to be cool. But, you know, shit, you got to calm down. Like, it ain't that deep, man. Take a breath, count to 10 and let it go. Like, goodness gracious, you know what I mean?
Exactly. That's the most racially slurred email I've seen in a long time. You know?
Very much so.
So, dog, before we close up the email post on the show tonight, what is your take on tonight's emails, brother?
Why are people so angry, bro? Like, why are people so angry when they email us, dog? Like, I don't know, man. Like, I understand people have frustrations. Like, I get it. I understand that. Well, people, when y'all email the show, feel free to say whatever you want, but, like, stop being so mad. Like, damn. People are very angry when they email us, man. But, hey, if you got to get something off your chest, I guess it's best to get it off in the, you know, confidentiality realm of an email. So I get it, but my take on tonight's email is people calm down, ease up on the racial epitaphs, and, you know, don't trip over small stuff, man. You know what I mean? Like, look, if you're dealing with somebody and they're not giving you the proper energy, chalk it up as a loss, move on. That's part of the game. Pimp strong and prosper. You know what I mean? That's really it. So, that's my whole thing.
Amen to that. So, folks, send more emails to holla at BossmanRadioShow.com. The best ones will be read on the air. And the least angry ones will be read next week. I guarantee you that. The least angry ones will be read next week. So, folks, after the break, we're going to preview the NFL playoffs on Bossman Show. TrueSpeech Thursday on the Bossman Radio Network and BossmanRadioShow.com. We back, people. More Bossman Show, TrueSpeech, after the break.
Hello, my name is Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consulting, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting or Twitter at Coach T Will 24 or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24. Or you can call me at 404-542-607. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Bossman Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
Hip-hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, TrueSpeech and 313 Fresh. We're going to give you two discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip-hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, IllStreetRex.com, and streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today. TrueSpeech and 313 Fresh, Family Grind ENT. Believe in it. Get it.
TrueSpeech Thursday on the Bossman Radio Network at BossmanRadioShow.com. Hope you enjoyed listening to the emails. They was crazy as always. Now we're going to go to something we know a lot about, the NFL. Season came to a close, dog, and a lot of teams, the playoffs are set. AFC, wild card playoffs. We got Pittsburgh in the Bengals. Chiefs, Texans, Bys are Denver and New England. In the NFC, Cam Newton, 15-1 with a bye. Arizona with a bye. Seattle at Minnesota. And we got Green Bay at Washington, dog. And after all this, we have some firings. The Browns fire GM Ray Farmer and Mike Pettine. Also, we have Chuck Pagano staying with the Colts as well. Jim Thompson with Allen San Francisco. Also to go with the Dolphins already firing Joe Philbin. Also the Titans firing Ken Whistlehunt, letting go with Rustin Webster on Black Monday. And also we also have another more opening as well in the league. So Speech and Chip Kelly got fired by the Eagles as well. So all these firings, dog. So the NFL, man, it's been a weird year, weird offseason now starting already. So Tom Coughlin resigned from the Giants as well. So a lot of stuff going on, dog. So what is your take on the firings first? And then on the wild card playoffs, what are you expecting from in that? And for you being in Detroit as well, can you answer this question? Will Jim Caldwell remain the Lions coach after they hire a new GM?
All right, well, I'm gonna holler at the firings first. I'm not surprised by any one of the firings. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm surprised that Chip Kelly got fired before the last game of the season. That was a shock. I knew he was gone. But the way that, you know, the Eagles let him go, I was like, damn, dude, they couldn't even let him finish out the season. It was one game left. But that also shows the urgency that they had in order to get Chip Kelly out of there and then just start the reshuffling process and the reorganizing of the Philadelphia Eagles. Because let's be honest, though, they've had a couple of disappointing seasons and some blunders. I mean, dude, cut DeSean Jackson, LeSean McCoy, and you bring in DeMarco Murray, and look what happened. It's really disappointing. So there were some crucial missteps by Chip Kelly, so the Eagles definitely wanted to get the ground rolling. Apparently, they just wanted to make it happen before the end of the season, so that was a little rough. Not really surprised that, you know, Jim Tom Sula got fired. I mean, I really saw that coming, bro. Like, I'm not shocked about that one at all. The Titans, I'm not shocked. Chuck Pagano, we all knew he was going to be sticking around in the Colts because, let's be honest, dog, the Colts are not a bad team. They're not. And Chuck Pagano has done a great job, I feel, post-Peyton Manning, especially because, let's be honest, a lot of people had a lot of questions, you know, what's going to happen with the Colts after that. Is Andrew Luck going to live up to the hype? I think Andrew Luck has performed admirably. I really think he's performed really well. I think Chuck Pagano has done a great job. I'm all for that contract extension that they gave him. So that's cool. Tom Coughlin, I knew he was gone. You can't fire Tom Coughlin. Though, let's be honest. That just wasn't going to happen. He needed to leave on his own accord. And I think he was ready. You know, I mean, they don't have a team, I don't feel, in place that would have made a deep Super Bowl run or playoff run next year. I think they would have been, you know, so-so, kind of similar to this year or a little bit better. So I think it's kind of time to hit the refresh and the restart button on that. It's been a tumultuous year for the Giants anyway, so I think they needed a fresh restart. Nothing against Tom Coughlin. You know, definitely one of the best to ever do it, but it was just, you know, it was just a time, man. 15 years, two Super Bowls, a part of three altogether, and, you know, it was just time. You know, Tom Coughlin, I think, needs to take a step back from coaching. He's 70, and consider something in the front office. You know, I would love to see him in the front office of the Giants. I think he could do a lot of good there, you know, and I think that that's probably something that should happen. And to be honest, I think Jim Caldwell is going to keep his job in Detroit. He hasn't done a bad coaching job. I mean, the Lions were, what, 11-5 last year? Hell, let's be honest, they should have been 13-3. He was some questionable calls. And we're never going to forget all of the ridiculousness that happened with that ref situation. I mean, I'm still confused by how you pick up flags and all of that. Anyway, so the Lions would have had a much better season last year, barring referee interference and stupidity. So it's not like Jim Caldwell has done a bad job coaching. The year before Jim Caldwell got there, it was a horrible season in my eyes. Came in 11-5, took them to the playoffs, would have went to the second round. Hell, probably would have went past that. And would have had a better record, barring referee interference. So I think Jim Caldwell is going to keep his job. This year was a restructuring year, I feel, because we lost Sue, we lost Bailey, we lost a lot of solid defensive line players. That was really the strength of the Lions game last year. Our D-line was easily the best in the league. You know, and you can see our defensive numbers have gone on the downslide since then. Offensively, we're still trying to pick up some things, you know, but if you think about it, Megatron still got solid numbers. They underutilized him this year. Golden Tate, one of the top receivers in the league. So Ziggy Ansah on the defensive end, you know what I mean? Eric Ebron on the offensive end. Great cat, good talent. We have pieces. Jim Caldwell didn't do a bad job. The Lions just got screwed out of a couple games, and we just, you know, we beat ourselves most of the time. But you can't blame that on Jim. It's the Lions, man. So that's kind of my take on all the firings, honestly, and the restructuring and the reshuffling.
Yes, indeed. And now we go to the playoffs, dog. First game we have, we're going to start in the NFC, Vikings in Seattle. Seattle beat the Vikings 38-7 at TCL Bank Stadium earlier this season. But that's before Teddy Bridgewater got his legs under him, got more comfortable. AP's not more comfortable. I think in the cold, Russell Wilson's throwing game may be affected a little bit. And Minnesota's been playing some lights-out defense. They've been underrated by how good they've been playing under Mike Zimmer, who always coaches defense up really, 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 really good. Love the way he got coach defense. And I think in a tight game speech, in the cold, out at TCL Bank Stadium, that the Vikings will win a tough game. Looking like, I must say, 20-17 over Seattle in the wild card playoffs, dog.
You know, you said 2017 Vikings.
Yeah.
I can't argue with that because, like you said, Teddy Bridgewater is now becoming a lot more comfortable with his position. I think he's becoming more comfortable with making decisions and leading the game and not just being a game manager, but actually being a leader and a quarterback. Because, you know, I mean, you got AP in the backfield, dog. I know people's in Teddy head like, look, just hand the ball to AP and move out the way. Just manage the game. But his decision-making is becoming a lot better. So I think that Teddy Bridgewater is really evolving as a young quarterback. I like the kid. I think he's a great kid. I think he's a great talent. And I'm excited to see it. And what you said really made a lot of sense. Seattle has to come to Minnesota. As we know, dog, it's 12 degrees here in Michigan. I can only imagine how cold it is in Minnesota. So it's going to play a factor. That's going to play a factor. I think that's definitely going to determine Russell Wilson's skill set, how well is he in the cold. AP and the Vikes, they know the business. So I think they're going to be a lot more comfortable there. And I think the Vikings have been on a real hot streak the past couple weeks, man. They riding the wave, bro. They really riding the wave, man. Momentum means a lot in this game. And I think right now the Vikings got momentum.
And staying in the NFC, the team that the Vikings beat to win the NFC North for the first time since 2009, Aaron Rodgers and the Packers travel to D.C. to play the Redskins. For me, I'm the Green Bay Packers. I like this matchup. I want to play Washington rather than playing Seattle. Because the Green Bay Packers, dog, cannot get off the line of scrimmage. They can play in press man coverage. Their receivers cannot get open. And the Redskins don't scare me. That's the best people who cover in the whole world. So, Kirk Cousins, Aaron Rodgers, I think that they will beat those boys down in D.C. and wait to see whether they'll be going to Carolina or they'll be going to Arizona. Dog, what is your feeling about that?
I will say this. I'm glad the Vikings won. I mean, I'm not a Packers fan. You can't be a Lions fan and a Packers fan. It just don't work that way. It's like being a Lions fan and a Bears fan. It's not gonna happen. I do like the Packers. I'm not going to lie. I like them. I don't love them. But I think Aaron Rodgers right now, bro, is just something going on with the Packers. I can't explain. There's more so of a watching them and the vibe of the team. And they're going through some things right now because they haven't had as much success as predicted. And I think they're battling a lot of internal conflict. And right now, Washington, dog, Kirk Cousins is playing lifestyle football, dude. I mean, the kid is solid right now. You know, I think the Redskins, their confidence is up there. They're riding the wave. You know, Kirk Cousins, the man, he got the starting job. You know, they moved on past RG3. And I think right now, once again, like I said about Minnesota, bro, Washington is riding this wave. The energy is up. They're confident. They feeling themselves. They have a solid game plan. I think they're going to execute. Don't count out Washington. Don't do it. If I had to bet money, I'm going to split down the middle, man. I think it can go either way. If I had to call it, dog, I'd say, cool. I'm going to say 23-20. It's going to be the score. And it's either going to be Washington or Green Bay. It's going to be a close-scoring game. I think Kirk Cousins is going to let it fly. I think Aaron Rodgers is definitely going to let it fly. Green Bay has a few more weapons offensively, I believe. Especially with the deep ball, so I can't count you out, dog. I'm going to say 23-20 Green Bay.
All right. Well, folks, that's been your NFC playoff preview. Coming up after the break, we'll break down to the AFC and give you the top things we can stop doing in 16 on the Bossman Show. TrueSpeech Thursday on the Bossman Network and BossmanRadioShow.com. More TrueSpeech Thursday after the break on the Bossman Show.
Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consultant, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting or Twitter at Coach TWill24 or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24. Or you can call me at 404-542-6079. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Bossman Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
Hip-hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, TrueSpeech and 313 Fresh. We're going to give you 2 discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip-hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, IllStreetRex.com, and streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today, TrueSpeech and 313 Fresh, Family Grind ENT. Believe in it, get it.
Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team in. Started from the bottom, now we here.
Folks, welcome back to the Bossman Show. TrueSpeech Thursday, the Bossman Network, BossmanRadioShow.com. We back at it. If we're going to preview the AFC wild card round playoffs with you now. Speech, first game we're going to start off with is the battle of the AFC North. Pittsburgh, Cincinnati, without Andy Dalton. This is the team the people that want to play. Big Ben and Sluss, their offense they have. Their defense is very mediocre, but their offense, with Antonio Brown, Martavis Bryant, Marcus Wheaton, and Heath Miller, them boys can score the ball and Big Ben can throw it around the yard, can win you some games in a shootout, dog. If you ask me, the Bengals, once again, without Andy Dalton, will lose in the first round of playoffs, and Marvin Lewis will still be winning some playoffs, and that will be more questions for Marvin Lewis going forward. But I got you. The Steelers will win this game 31-17 over the Bengals at Paul Brown Stadium.
I absolutely 100% agree, dog. Like, I couldn't have said it better myself. Andy Dalton's out. The Bengals are a great team, but they're not the same without Andy Dalton. There's no way they can really mesh with how well the Pittsburgh Steelers are not only coached, their Roethlisberger's on the road. You're not going to outscore or stop Antonio Brown, dog. And the Steelers have been together too long, man. They know how to win. They've been here before. They got the moment, dog. And this is just another year for Pittsburgh, man. It's another day. I agree with that score, too. I think it's going to be about 31-17 Pittsburgh. So I'm 100% behind you and in agreement on that. Go Steelers. Swing on my terrible towel since my Lions ain't in the playoffs.
And now we move to the least of the games. KC, the Chiefs, who have won, get this dog, 10 games in a row without Jamal Charles, out for the year with a torn ACL. 11-5. The Texans, quick in the playoffs at 9-7 in the AFC South. Now, this game right here, dog, is pretty simple. The Chiefs have an offensive line that can keep the Texans rushers at bay. And I feel their defense can beat the Texans offense with Brian Hoyer, Nate Washington. Now, DeAndre Hopkins is a beast, but you bracket that guy up. You got Nate Washington and those guys. I see KC winning this game. Andy Reid, Allison winning their first game together in the playoffs and going on to play probably, if you ask me, New England in the divisional round, while Pittsburgh goes to play Denver in Denver, with Pete or Oswald will be playing. So, dog, if you ask me today, KC 27, Houston 13.
I say 2-17 Kansas City. I don't think Houston's really going to put up solid numbers like that, dog. A lot of people sleep on that Kansas City defense. That Kansas City defense ain't no slouch. And like you said, their O-line and KC is solid, man. You know, I love me some J.J. Watt, dog, but I don't really think he's going to be effective, don't get me wrong. I just think that KC has weapons on the offensive line side of the ball that can slow down J.J. Watt. I'm not saying stop him because you can't stop the man. He's a monster. He's a Mack truck. But I think they're going to be able to slow down his progress. And KC got weapons, dog. I mean, they got weapons. Even without Jamal Charles, I honestly didn't see him going 11-5, bro. But here they are. Andy Reid know what he's doing. The team is solid, bro. Alex Smith, highly underrated at the QB spot. So, I really think that KC going to pull it out, dog. I don't see Houston putting up more than 10 points, bro. Let's be honest, dog. The AFC South,
really was the hottest division in football. No disrespect to the Texans, dog. I'm not trying to throw salt on the Texans. Let's be honest. Who was really in a division this year? Dog? The whole division was terrible. Let's be 100. You know what I mean? So I'm just throwing that out there, dog. Kansas City. Houston, sweet by. They was better than everybody else in their division, which wasn't that good in the first place. Houston's got problems they need to address. So I don't really see them making pass this game. So just throwing it out there.
True that, dog. And we're going to move on to our last few minutes on the show this week. Things must stop in 2016, dog. I got two things. Bad takes and bad emails. They must stop. Those two things. Well, I got three. Bad takes, bad emails, getting our names wrong. Must stop 2016. They
got to
stop.
It's got to, man. Because our names ain't hard, man. We've been at this for years, dog. You should know our names by now. I mean, damn, come on now. So I'm with you on that, dog. Bad takes, bad emails. Get your take together. Get your talk together. Get your email game right. You know what I mean? Email us, dog. We love to chop it up with y'all, but you got to understand. You got to come right on the email. We don't have to talk about you. Also, please get our names right. JR the Boss, man. JR or Boss. True Speech. True and or Speech. That's it. Please address it right. So one thing I think we need to stop, man, in 2016, seriously, I'm really tired of this phenomenon of dudes wearing wigs, like, oh, in a comedy. I'm really tired of that, man. Like, I'm really tired of seeing cats thinking they're comedians and they put a wig on and crack some jokes, man. Nah, you just riding the wave. Everybody's doing it. It's not cool. That needs to stop, dog. That needs to stop. Also, in 2016, please stop thirst trapping by telling everybody who you finna cut off, how lonely you are, how ugly you are. This is for comics. Like, yo, step your social media game up. Just do you and be you. Stop fishing for sympathy and fake compliments. Like, please stop doing that. To me, male or female, you look like a sucker. Like, please stop doing that. Just be you. That's the motto for 2016. Be you, stop fronting, quit the games, quit the BS, man. It's a new year. Chill out with the garbage. Leaving 2015. 2016, let's move towards something new, man. That's, dude, for real, though.
And another bad take. Stop posting pictures of people laying on a deathbed dead in the hospital or at their home laying there dead or in the casket or posing
or
with
the
casket.
The casket, dog.
Stop!
Yes.
I hate logging to Facebook and seeing that. And also, why do you gotta go announce on Facebook somebody died? I don't get that either. And why do you like it?
Dude.
Why are you liking that somebody died? Why?
I'll be so confused, bro. Like, I don't know if people are liking to support or if they're liking to say, I'm glad this person is no longer here. Like, it's very confusing. You know what I mean? If you're putting up funeral arrangements like, hey, yo, here's the services or whatever, or, you know, if you want to send prayers, thoughts, condolences, cards, remarks to the family, you can do that. But like you said, bro, let's please stop. I'm so tired of funeral selfies. I think that's so disrespectful. You know what I mean? Like, dog, that's not cool.
Getting ready to go to
home. Sure
getting ready to go to Grenade's homegoing service. Or at Gray's funeral. Looking nice. No! That's not something to promote. What's your problem?
Right. Oh, dog, that's not a turn up moment. That's a turn down. Turn down for grieving. Like, for real, bro. For real. You're 100% right, dog. We got to stop the funerals and hospital bed selfies in 2016. I'm so tired of that, dog. I'm so tired of that. Like, for real. Also in 2016, let's please, fellas, buy pants that fit to stop wearing them stupid-ass joggers. I hate them. Buy some man pants, bro. Buy some regular sweatpants. Stop wearing the skinny jean nut huggers. Just put you on some pants that fit, clean cut, tailored fit. You know what I mean? Not super baggy, not super tight. Get you some man pants. Sellers, put on man clothes in 2016. Let's stop wearing girl clothes. Quit shopping in your little sister closet.
Amen to that, folks. And folks, that is your first edition of Boss Man Show. TrueSpeech Thursday on the Boss Man Network, BossManRadioShow.com this year. Dog. Great show as always. We'll do it again next week, brother. Bringing the noise even harder and maybe cause an uprising or two in the process.
It's what we do best.
Because we are potentially hazardous brothers from another mother.
Hey.
Hey, speech before you go in less than seconds. I always love the language of our friends. That's some of the best language ever.
Some of the most ridiculous PC, non-PC, old circle talking garbage, man. It's comical, dog. It really is comical. Like, we don't own thesauruses, or we don't, or we're not well versed in the English language. We know what you're saying. Just say it, man. Man up and say it, partner.
Yeah. What's happening, partner? Well, look here, folks. That was we show. We out.
Hello, my name is Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consulting, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting, or Twitter at Coach TWill24, or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24. Or you can call me at 404-542-6079. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Bossman Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
Hip-hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, True Speech and 313 Fresh. We're going to do two discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip-hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, illstreetrex.com, and streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today. True Speech and 313 Fresh. Family Grind ENT. Believe in it. Get it.